Hey Shopify store owners, in this video, Justin will be showing you how to do basic keyword research for your Shopify store.
Hi, this is Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to do basic keyword research. Now we're going to be using a tool called the Google AdWords Keyword Planner. So you can find this simply by searching Google Keyword Planner, and you have it as the first result. And once you arrive at this page, you can simply select this top option. And we're going to put in a few keywords that describe what it is that we are looking to learn more about. So for instance, if my blog is about, you know, dog toys, things you can do with your dog, that kind of thing, we can type in things like dog. And then we're going to add a new line every time we need a new keyword. And we can add longer keywords as well, such as dog toys, fun, pet activities, dog parks, dog food. Basically what we're doing is we're trying to find new keywords to blog about, write about, etc. So we can enter a product category just to give us better results. But because I'm looking for more broad results, I'm going to keep on all categories for now. I can of course change this later. Okay, so I can mess with some of these. For instance, I can change what locations I'm looking at, what languages. I'm just going to select English, and I will keep everything the way it is, and we'll click Get Ideas. Now what we're going to do is go over here to Keyword Ideas, and if we scroll down, we're going to see that there are tons of keywords for us. As you can see here at the bottom, there's over 800 keywords. And that's a lot of keywords, and more than what we are ready to look at. So one of the things I can do is see what kind of keywords and things are found interesting to my current blog audience. So I'm going to use a tool called the Blog Social Analyzer. So if I just go ahead and select the first result, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in the RSS feed URL for my blog. So once I paste it in, I'm just going to hit the go button. And we're going to wait while this pulls up all of the social information about the posts. Okay, so if we scroll down, one of the things you'll probably see first is that Twitter is getting the most attention from these readers. So most people are going to be sharing via Twitter. There are a few on Facebook, hardly any with Google+, LinkedIn, or StumbleUpon, or Reddit. So if we look, one of the most popular ones here is for a pet charity donation. This one's for another event for dogs. This one's for a giveaway. Another giveaway. So we can kind of see what these readers are interested in just from these quick stats. This will basically give us a good idea of what kind of keywords we want to be looking at. So if we go back to our keywords tool, as you can see, some of these keywords are being searched thousands of times per month. If we hover over the trend bar, we can see that this is a pretty steady trend, and this would be a pretty good keyword to use. However, if you search for best dog food, the results are going to be incredibly competitive and probably not something we're going to be able to get to the top of for the results. So what I'm going to do instead is click on average monthly searches twice, and on the second time it's going to show me the results with the least amount of average monthly searches. Now 10 isn't really a whole lot, so I'm going to scroll down and keep looking until I find something that's more appropriate for my level of blog. And this is really going to depend on how good your blog is, how established it is, etc. So maybe we can go to the next one. So for instance, this one right here, dry dog foods, this one might be good. One of the things we can do to analyze how hard the competition is we can actually just search it using Google. I'm using a Google Chrome plugin called the Mozbar. So if we scroll down, you'll see that I have this extra link analysis for my results. And to get this for your web browser, all you need to do is search for Mozbar. And if you're using Google Chrome, you've got it in the web store right here. And there's also one for Firefox. So if we look at these results, right here is the page authority. This will tell you how authoritative this specific page is, and the domain authority, or DA, shows you how authoritative the domain by itself is. So this first result right here is pretty solid. As you can see, it's got several links to just the page. Now, as you can see, this first result is very solid. It's got a high page authority and domain authority. But if we scroll down, this one only has 35, this one has 37. That being said, most of these are above 30, and it might be hard for us to get even on the front page. So instead, what I'm going to do is look for another result to try. So now we can try educational dog toys. Once again, I'm just going to search it. And this one might be a little bit easier. As you can see, the second result, the page authority is only 25, and it's only got 5 links. Now, the domain authority is still quite high, but if we keep scrolling down, we've got another one with 24, 25, especially this one right here, only page authority of 22 and a low domain authority. I think we could definitely get at least to this result right here, especially here at the bottom, very low page authority, and right here, very low page authority and low domain authority. So this might be a good keyword to use, educational dog toys. Now, we aren't done looking at this keyword. There are still some things we can look at to make sure it is one we want to talk about. One of the things that we need to look at is the suggested bid. This is basically a metric set up by Google that will tell you how much people are willing to pay to show up for this result. Now, it's 57 cents, which is not awful, but it's not very high. One of the ways you can tell that people are willing to buy products whenever they search for something like educational dog toys is that the suggested bid is high. If the suggested bid is low, which 57 cents isn't that high, that means that people aren't really willing to buy whenever they are searching for this keyword. Now, another keyword, such as best dog food to buy, obviously people are ready to buy something, so that is why this keyword has a very high suggested bid. So what we need to make sure of is that the suggested bid is high enough to know that this keyword does have commercial ability and that people are looking to buy your products. So like I said, educational dog toys, sure, we could get on the front page, however, it's not quite high enough for the suggested bid. So at this point, maybe what we should do is go back to that first page again and see if we can find something that's a little bit easier to rank for but still has a high suggested bid. So we try great dog toys. Let's see if that is a good keyword to use. As you can see, this one's got a low page authority, however, an incredibly high domain authority, so that might be a tough one. But this one right here, low page authority, decent domain authority. Now, this one's also not that strong, with a decent page authority, low domain authority. And if we keep scrolling, this looks like a good one to use. As you can see, we've got a lot of results with lower page and domain authorities. So great dog toys may be a good keyword to include in our blog post. Now, like I said earlier, it does have a decent suggested bid at $1. Also, the average monthly searches is 70, which may not sound that high. However, the good thing about this is that if we use a lot of keywords similar to this, even if we find 5 or 10, that's 350 to 700 searches every month, and that can lead to more customers. This has been Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos about e-commerce marketing.